This video is an introduction to using the MU Libraries website to quickly search and find library resources. You're probably asking, why don't I just use Google to find what I need? And that's even if you open this video at all. The issue with using Google is that it doesn't search scholarly publications and academic journals. In fact, it can be difficult for Google to cough up even mainstream news sources from a few years ago. And then you might even hit a paywall. Paywall is when an information provider requests payment for accessing the materials. We know you don't have the money to access all of those materials and pay for them. Here's the thing, MU Libraries already pays for it. We pay for access to a wide range of research materials, from newspapers to scholarly journals to ebooks and more, and it costs us a ton of money every year. You get this access because you're affiliated with MU. To get access to these materials, the best place to start is the MU Libraries website. Regular Google just doesn't find what you're going to need to do college-level work. The MU Libraries website is library.missouri.edu, and that's where we're starting today. In the middle, you'll see a gray box with two tabs, Discover at MU and Books and Media. These are essentially two different sets of materials that you're searching. Discover at MU is more or less a way to search online information. The Books and Media tab is more or less about physical materials, like books or DVDs or bound journals that are on the shelves. There is some overlap between these two searches, but that's pretty much what the difference is. Let's start with a search on Discover at MU. Let's look up mollusks. I'm going to type in freshwater mollusks and hit search. Right away, I can see that I have a ton of results that have popped up. The first result is an academic journal. I can see that from the icon under the title. I can look at the title and see whether it sounds like it will fit my research needs. I can also review the subjects under the title and see if it matches what I'm looking for. Let's say it does. I'm going to click on the title. You're probably expecting that clicking on the title will take me to the article itself. It does not. Instead, it takes me to the bibliographic citation. I can see over here on the left side of the screen the link for the PDF full text, but I'm going to caution you not to click right there and jump into skimming the article. The reason is that academic sources are fairly dense and not really up for skimming, but the bibliographic citation includes the abstract or summary of the article, and this is good for skimming first. If you're still interested in the article after that, then you can click through to the PDF. You can read it now or save it to read later. Take a look at this list of tools on the right side of the page. From here, you can save to Google Drive, or you can also email the article to yourself. What you do not want to do is save the URL at the top of the screen to come back to this later. Do not do this. The URL is a session URL, and it will expire in a few minutes. Instead, use the permalink in the tools list and use that URL to save your place. That one will not expire. Back to the search results. Let's look at some of the ways to filter your search on the left side of the page. You can change the publication date, you can filter for ebooks, you can even limit to only peer-reviewed or academic journals. Remember that, that's going to come up early and often in your college career, and you'll want to know how to find peer-reviewed journals. Let's go back to the library.missouri.edu page and take a look at the other tab, Books and Media. Click on that tab, and the gray box changes to a different form of search. Here I'm going to search for Alfred Hitchcock. As a reminder, this search is for physical materials, books, DVDs, and so on. You can see that the results page is quite different. The first result is an ebook. I can click on it and see the citation for the book and then click straight through to the book itself if I want. The second link is a physical book in the collection at Ellis Library. When I click on this title, I can see the citation and also find the call number for the book. The call number is the identifier that will help me find the book on the shelves at Ellis Library. This was an introduction to using the MU Libraries website for quick searching of materials at the libraries. If you have any questions, check out our chat widget on the library website. It will connect you with MU librarians who can help you find what you need.